isn't it nice when everything is in order, organized, not all these things laying around? Entangled, strung about. People, we have to clean here. Or maybe later. But what happens when we take wireless transmission a step further and apply it to energy, to our grid, to the power supply system? That's what we are going to discuss in today's episode of What's What. But before we get started, be sure to like and subscribe below. So, say we have wireless transmission systems without a physical link, which operates with a transmitter device. And this device is driven by electric power from a power source, generating a time-varying electromagnetic field. It is the field that then transmits power across space to a receiver, and a receiver which extracts power from the field and supplies it to an electrical device. And voila, we have power. There are various methods to achieve wireless transmission, some more developed than others, such as inductive coupling, which provides short-range, low-directive flow under a hertz to megahertz frequency from wire-coiled antennas. Inductive coupling-based stations may be used for daily life small devices, like your smartphone or even an electric toothbrush. Regarding wireless transmission, there is also the microwave beam method, which creates long fields with high directive levels under a terahertz frequency from lasers, photocells, or lenses. This can be used to charge your phone, power drone, and other more complex devices. We will get into more of these methods later, but right now, to get a broader understanding, let's look at the basics of what science utilizes to create wireless transmission. Nikola Tesla dreamed of wireless global electricity, and if he was alive today, he would see his dream starting to come true. But this is no easy stuff. When dealing with wireless transfer, we can break it down into two groups that each have functions, methods, and sub-methods of transfer. First, there is near-field, which utilizes electromagnetic induction to transport wireless energy. Second, there is far-field transmission, which uses electromagnetic radiation. Where electromagnetic induction produces electromotive force in a changing magnetic field, electromagnetic radiation creates electric and magnetic disturbance to transmit energy. Each of these processes have subcategories that vary in degrees of operation: dynamic induction, static induction, laser and microwave power, resonant induction, and so on. But to keep things simple, we're going to take a deeper look into inductive coupling first. Inductive coupling falls under the near-field side of electrical power transmission. It utilizes magnetic fields over short distances, from a few centimeters to meters, and works with two coils, one emitter, one receiver. These two coils modify the voltage of a particular system by providing an alternating current that creates an oscillating magnetic field. The magnetic field then passes through a receiving coil and induces an alternating electromagnetic field, which in turn pushes current into the receiver. Next, the receiver transfers the power load, or changes it, into DC current via a rectifier. When dealing with coupling, matching coil dimensions are essential. The conditions of success are small distance between coils, flat surface, and a magnetic permeable material. And we've only touched the surface of one type of field wireless energy transfer. What inductive coupling is to near-field electric transfer, power beaming is to far-field electric transfer. And as mentioned, it transfers power via electromagnetic radiation, much like your microwave or the use of laser technology. Because power beaming falls under the far field side of the transfer spectrum, it can transfer energy longer distances, as far as satellites used in outer space. But for the power beam to travel such distances, its transfer must hold very high directivity and be aimed precisely at a receiver. All this and wireless transfer systems are still at their early stages. There is no telling how they will evolve in the future. Let's do a quick recap to sum things up. Wireless transmission systems transfer power through space. It is a relatively new technology, but its potential has been contemplated for over a century. Wireless transmission can be separated into two categories, near field and far field, each with their own sub-methods. Inductive coupling is the most common near-field method of wireless energy transfer. And power beaming is an example of far-field wireless energy transfer. That's a wrap. What do you think about wireless energy transfer? Where do you see it taking us? And what powers does it hold? Feel free to leave us a comment below. Until next time, this is Frédéric from the What's What Studios. Tuning out.